This video is a first impression about Lord of the Rings Online. Keep in mind, this is not a review, it is just a first look to see how the game presents itself, so you can decide easier if it is for you or not. So, go grab a beer and stay tuned until the end and you will know for sure if you like Lord of the Rings Online. Let's start with the character creation. If you think this part is boring, you can skip to the gameplay section, but in that case, you owe me a beer. Here, we don't have nothing unusual and you can choose from Elf, High Elf, Hobbit, Dwarf or Stout Axe, that seems another kind of Dwarf. Then we have a new class that is called Björning and is something like a Druid. And finally the Man, that is referred to the Human class. So if you want to have a female, you will be from Man race. This game will trigger all the feminists out there, but don't judge the lore, the books were released a long time ago. The classes presented in the game are Burglar, Brawler, Captain, Guardian, Hunter and Minstrel, this is the healer one. Also, we have Lore Master, that is the mage class and not one that knows the lore of the game. We also can find Runekeeper and Warden. The game shows you from the start that it has pay to win elements because you can play some races like High Elf and some classes like Brawler or Warden only if you buy them with real money. I will not spend my hard earned money that are meant for beer to unlock a game class. Sorry Lord of the Rings. The character creation is kind of basic. I chose an elf and I could pick from a few hairstyle options, eye colors, and some face options like mouth or eyebrows. I can also choose the origin of my avatar, but it didn't seem to affect the starting zone of the game, and that is a shame. Okay, enough with the boring part. Let's check the most important section of a MMORPG, and that is the gameplay mechanic. The game starts with an incident in the Elven land, where I presume an important character named Talagan is killed. This name is more fit for a gun or a weapon, but I drink beer and play video games, so who am I to judge? After that, I start the game and got teleported into the main zone. The combat of Lord of the Rings is top targeted and it mimics the classic WoW theme where you have to face the enemy in order to hit him or to loot an object. You can shoot projectiles through trees or stones. And the abilities have some basic animation, but the game is old and not so high fantasy, so it is understandable. I can't really imagine some flashy skills here in this dark themed setting. They are on global cooldown, and some of them can be used only in combo situation, like for example, after I used my shield skill, I could choose to deliver an AoE damaging one or a single targeted one. At least this early in the game. Maybe at higher levels, you will be able to do all kinds of combinations. I had a Guardian class that I was trying to make into a Paladin-like one with healings and debuffs perks. At level 10, you unlock 3 main traits that you can follow. I had to choose from the one mentioned before or 2 more. One that was a DPS build with bleed and one tanky with defense and taunts. This feature is great in any game because it lets you customize your character further. It was nice if I could put points wherever I wanted in this trait system, not only in one path. Another thing that felt like I can do what I want in terms of build was that I was not restricted to play only with shields. I could handle a two-handed weapon with no problems and I could still see some parry indications showing up. A thing that I noticed early into the game is that when you press on a door, it actually opens. I know. Mind-blowing, right? For a game this old, to be able to open doors is insane. Also, I can jump like a deer. Just look how gracious I am. I bet you won't be able to be like this even after 10 beers. A different thing that Lord of the Rings Online does is when you fall from a higher height, you won't take any damage but you will be crippled for 45 seconds and you will walk slower. The animation is also changing, making you look like a zombie or to be in the beer team, like a drunken person looking for his way home. Before going forward for the next section, I just want to brag that at one point I had Gucci pants on me. A medieval male version of them that really gave me swag when doing missions in the Middle Earth. Also, if you enjoy beer as much as me and you think the video is nice until now, support me with a like. Thank you, fellow virtual drinking buddy. Let's talk about the setting and the questing. Well, like the name suggests, the game Lord of the Rings is set in the same universe of the original books. The game is dark fantasy and it is really atmospheric. You will feel like a genuine adventurer in this environment full of dangers at any corner. The tone is dark and gritty and really invites you to feel like you are part of this universe. You will also find all kinds of environments, but for the early part of the game I was just into forests, some mountain peak and the citadel. About the graphics of the game, you have the option that supports DirectX 11 and it really improves the overall look of it, keeping up in the battle with time. There is even an existing day and night cycle, just for the atmosphere. You have the main story that follows incidents from the books, but if you are like me and you just saw the movies, you won't really understand them that much. And yeah, I know, I am not worthy to do this video, but for my defense, I have an intention to read them because of the great mythology aspects that Tolkien created. The quests are interesting and with plenty of characters showing up and doing different kind of tasks with them. Then, you have secondary missions. They may be part of the main plot line, or they can be random, like killing X amount of creatures. At first, I was really bored of doing quests. And by first, I mean at level 3 or maybe 4. After that, they felt kindly like an adventure, with dungeons to explore, and missions where you have to help somebody to destroy a camp of bad dwarves, or even save a Vorton. Forget Telegan. This is by far the most weird name for a character, not only for an elf, because you will think of... And I won't say any more here, but I think you can realize by yourself. Come on, you are an adult, you can buy your beer by yourself from the shop and nobody will ask for your ID. I think you got it, a Vorton. It was also nice that some players were hopping now and then, so the game did not felt dead. I couldn't reach the main city to see the population that is still playing Lord of the Rings Online, because there is the chilling base of every endgame player in every MMORPG. Rest assured, the game isn't dead and you will find players that are questing in the world, even at low levels. Okay, so before we check the pros and the cons of the game, let me tell you some reasons you should consider subscribing to the channel. First of all, we drink plenty of beer here. This should be enough, but for a bonus, you will get more similar videos about games and will know if something is for you or not, so in the end, you won't have to waste your precious time. I will mostly cover MMORPGs, RPGs, roguelikes, metroidvanias, and anything that is similar to this spectre or has action in it. So, if you decided you want to join the beer and gaming community, you know where the big red button that says subscribe is. In conclusion, Lord of the Rings Online is a really atmospheric top-targeted MMORPG based on the WoW mechanic systems set in the universe of the original books that share the same name as the title. It was a little bit boring for me at first, but then I got immersed into it and really enjoyed my short time here. From what I understand, the game really does a good job presenting you the original story by missions, and if you are a fan of the franchise, you must not overlook this game and you have to jump into it right now, especially that you don't have to buy a subscription for it anymore. I can't really say something bad about the game. All of that being said, if you are a fan of Lord of the Rings franchise, you won't find at the moment a better simulator of it that has multiplayer options too. Maybe the game will get a sequel in the future to be able to compete with the recent generation of games. That will wrap the video for today. Thank you guys for watching, and may the gods of good rub be with you in your grindy days. Also, don't forget, after a night of heavy drinking, be sure to stay hydrated.